In Pennsylvania, 60% of our cropland is highly erodible land. And so it is important to take soil erosion seriously.
The soil is our livelihood, and we don't want to see it leaving our farm. We're farming around 700 acres, 450, 500 of that is corn, and the rest is soybeans that are double cropped in back of the wheat and barley. Much like Lancaster County, our farm has rolling topography. And I remember one afternoon, we had a thunderstorm that washed mud out on the road, and I could actually see some of my freshly planted soybeans in with the mud. And I've been no-tilling for a long time, but at that point, I knew that what I was doing was not adequate.
He wasn't really using cover crops at that time. So I told him, we always want to have living vegetation in the field, because research has shown that it helps to protect the soil from erosion. Also, those roots help to maintain the soil in a healthy state. He really took that.
For cover crops on my farm, I primarily use wheat. In recent years, I've been adding some canola, rapeseed, hairy vetch to diversify. Some of the pros and cons of using cover crops, I guess a con would be the expense. You have to buy cover crop. And the first year you do it, you might say, well, I had this seed expense. I had to sow it. And then come spring, now I have to kill it. The pros would be the fact that it helps with water management, nutrient management, and insect management. And the pros far outweigh the cons.
Cover crops have become quite widely used among dairy farmers. But with the vegetable farmers and the grain farmers, it has been more of a challenge. Our SARE project is focused on how do we stimulate vegetable farmers and grain farmers to use cover crops more. Our project was really focused on giving farmers who had not used cover crops before the opportunity to use cover crops by donating some seed to them.
We actually were able to distribute 5 bags of seed per farmer to a number of farmers, and then hopefully they will like it.
And then we asked them to fill out a form to share their observations with us, so we could use that then again in outreach.
A farmer can sort of feel like, well, a farmer's independent. Farmer likes to do his own thing. And sometimes the farmer's not real wild about sharing what they're doing with other people. But the sharing part of it is part of the process of becoming better farmers.
The unique role I think SARE plays is its emphasis on outreach and impact.
I think Pennsylvania is one of the largest in the nation that's using no-till and cover crops.
When I started in the year 2000, 20% of our planted acres was no-tilled, and today it is 65%. I really attribute the increased adoption of no-tillage and also now cover crops to really that partnership amongst farmers, agribusinesses, USDA, Pennsylvania Department of Agriculture. If we can all work together, we can accomplish a lot more than if we each do our own thing.